Alrighty, so we've got a HP ProBook G1840 EliteBook. Problem apparently is this. That's it. I think we do see a flickering of a backlight attempt, but nothing. So what's the issue? No idea. It's from another tech. Let's see if we can help them out. So alright, no battery, Windows license. Ah, it's the crappy model. The screws. Okay. It turns on then off. Okay, unfortunately there's two BIOS looking like chips. Hopefully it's a BIOS chip issue. Let's just do a CMOS reset first. Where should we start? BIOS will be a good option to start. Let me see what kind of BIOS chips are here. And so we've got, so that's not the BIOS, this is the BIOS, 16 megabyte file. Yeah, let's just give it a crack. Okay. Okay. Okay, so I don't even know the exact model. Let's see. EliteBook G1840. Bummer, there's two files, all right. Okay, so there's two files. Let's call it EliteBook 840 G1. And we'll make a new folder called bad files. Okay, let's go to the programmer. Okay, cancel smart identify. All right, read. We do need to remove the other chip too, I think. We'll try one chip at a time. Okay, so let's call that file there, done. Now let's program this one. We'll say open. The 128 one. Okay, right. While that's going on, I'll put this folder as a shortcut in the quick access. And there we go. Okay, let's see how this will go. We should technically do both of them, I think, but I don't know which one is at fault, so we'll just do one at a time and let's see what happens. Sorry, I didn't. Okay. Let's see. No, I forgot to connect the cable for a laptop. Shit, quick. battery's gonna die on that. Oh man. Oh, that's better, okay. Yes, charging great, okay. I'm doing cloning on another machine. Okay, so where are you, Mr. Charger? There you are, okay. And power on. Let's double check this power is in properly. Oh yeah, here we go. At least light is staying on longer. Power light is on. Three long. So standard three beeps. EliteBook. Three LEDs. Caps lock. Okay. Let's check the RAM. It's the previous tech, probably played around. So that's 8 gig DDR3L. Unusually warm for a RAM that's just plugged in. Okay, that's air 4 gigabyte DDR3L. One, two, three. Okay. All right. Let's try the next slot. DDR3L is backwards compatible, so I'll try and get a non-DDR3L. Oh, here we go, it works. It might be in manufacturing mode. Okay, enter. Right, nice. I'm happy with that. So it's good I didn't flash the second one, I think. We'll switch the RAM back, let's see what will happen. Interesting. That RAM has gone kaput. Okay, DDR3. Now what does this guy need? DDR3L or DDR3, let me see. 2 gigs, one of these. Whole bunch of DDR3. I think he wants DDR3L, okay. That's his one. Okay, let's see if 8 gigs is recognized. Yeah, 8 gigabyte, 1.6 gigahertz. Okay, so in that case, what we'll do is this. I don't want to give them the one low voltage one because we need it for other jobs. It's more compatible. Put a 4 gig standard one. Bummer, it was still on, was it? Okay. Okay, he's happy with DDR3 as well. Okay, great. So what we'll do? Low voltage. It's a 2 gig. What is that doing in there? Something ideally same speed. Okay. DDR3L. You go inside different box. You go in there. S. For some reason I don't trust that guy. Okay, we got two high quality Samsungs. They will be fine. Let's go. Elpida. Who remembers Elpida? Are they still in business? Oh, is it working at all? Oh, it is, yeah, okay. Enter to reset, okay. Okay. Unsupported DDR memory type is not supported. Okay. Alright, understandable. He wants DDR3L. Alright, we'll give it to you, mate. Don't fucking cry. Okay. Which ones are high speed? 1200. 1200, 1200. Okay, there we go. However, I didn't complain about the other ones. Okay. Okay, let's put the BIOS battery. Okay, let's try the cloning again. Alright, system info, yes, okay. Advanced. Okay, the boot options, we want to boot from a USB, do a quick memory test. Oh, what have they got? A memory test, or I will run that. I think that will be it for this. I'll let it run, put the cover back on. Yeah, if there's any issues, I'll come back to the video. If not, that will be the end of this video. So for now, thanks for watching. See you in the next one.
Thanks for watching. Please subscribe to support this channel.